YouTube. This is day 12 of the lockdown. We passed hump day. Hump day was yesterday. And today is Tuesday, if you forgot. With that saying, let us give you an update on our sprouts. One is ready, one is not.
Do the chickpeas first. As you can see, it's a bit mulky. Take it around. Save the water, and then I'll water it out here. The sprouts are going strong. It is a bigger, hardier seed, that's why it's taking a bit longer. Now for our winners. As you can see, it's running clear, no milkiness to the water, and a whole lot of development from the sprouts. I think I might just have some for breakfast. And remember, all of this is just from 2 tablespoons of seed. It's how much sprouts you get for 2 tablespoons of seed. It's a good deal if you ask me. There we have our pizza from last night and some sprouts. Yay! Eating the harvest.
Hello YouTube. Thank you for joining me on my road again. Today we're going to be going to Fosloras. Fosloras is in Kuruleni. Kuruleni is on the east rand of Johannesburg. Thumbs up. Thank you, Tom, for your positive comments. Shout out to you. Another shout out goes to Ibrahim. Welcome, Ibrahim. I hope you enjoy my passenger seat. At least you don't have to wear gloves and masks while you travel with me on YouTube. This is a small town called Walkerville. Walkerville is a small agricultural town with a few markets. Awesome place to spend your Saturdays when there's no lockdown. They sell at the niche market, they sell craft beers, they have local produce, they have local honey, as well as a nursery and a lady that sells poultry. She sells chickens and quail. Now we're leaving the Val, going into Kuruleni. Back of Alberton, this is one of the industrial areas called L Road. Welcome to Tukosa Park. As you can see, it is busy. Not a lot of informal traders operating because the stalls are empty. Welcome to Fosloras, and we are currently on our way to Fosloras. Right now we're driving past Christani Mall in Fosloras. Now coming to a wholesaler here in Fosloras. Going on to the N3. The N3 highway is the highway between Durban and Johannesburg. we're going to be driving from Vosloorus to the Johannesburg region. This is the dairy. The dairy I always come to for some fresh whole milk, yogurt, and drinking yogurt. They sell kefir, they sell fresh cream, sour cream, feta cheese. They have a big range of dairy products from the processing from the dairy cows. They also only use Jersey cows. So that's some of the creamiest, best milk ever. It's a small farm here in the City Bank region called Eldred's Jerseys. And yes, you can see the young ones coming up on the left, but the older ones on the right. Just make you feel in touch of where your food comes from.
Welcome back. Today we're going to be planting some more. I'm happy. All our winter crops are going in now.
What we're going to do today is my garlic. I have garlic seed. This over here is from Tigro. I got this from the farmers.
How do we call this thing? Like an expo, a show. It's in Walkerville. It's called the Walkerville Agricultural Show. There we go. And at the Walkerville Agricultural Show, they share quite a bit of information.
I got
that from there. It's good, reliable seed. People have been talking about it. I'm also going to use companion planting. I'm going to use this raised bed over here.
This raised bed soil I got
at the spot I showed yesterday when I was telling you that I was collecting or harvesting soil. So companion planting is going to be carrots, going to be Swiss chard, as well as beetroot.
Yay. Beetroot is an all year crop. That's awesome. So beetroot from Mayford, and the rest from Stark Aris, and the last one is from a private producer.
So yeah, guys, not sponsored. Please sponsor me. I need the help, all the help I can get, doing this out of my pocket. As you can see, the sun is setting, so I'm gonna have some awesome light. But yeah, I'm tired. I've come from work, essential service, so essential employee. So yeah, life has to carry on. Let's do this. Another thing I might, or not might, I will be using is a watering can. Sticks for labeling, and a permanent marker so you can write on the sticks. Normal ice cream sticks. It's okay, it's not organic, but it's made out of wood, so it's a good thing to use instead of all the plastic. We do have some of the plastic ones, but we're not going to use them right now. So let's start planting. First I'm going to plant is the garlic seeds in the middle, because they're going to take the longest, then beet and carrots, and then some Swiss chard in between. This is the bright lights. Bright lights is better for you because it contains more colors. More colors means more nutrients. If you didn't know, now you know. So you saw I didn't use all the garlic seed. The reason for that is this is one bed I'm busy with now. That's has enough soil that I'm happy with. The next one is that one over there. So to fill up that one, I'm gonna have my second bed. Having the two beds mean you space out your harvest, so you don't harvest everything at once. Yes, it's gonna be close because I'm gonna try and do that one in this week. I also need to keep that seed safe, and I need to plant it as soon as possible because I'm going to miss the planting season if I don't do it right now. Cool.
On this side over here, we're going to be using these jiffy cups. In these jiffy cups, it's a peat cup with cocoa peat capsules, and these tablets swell. So what we do is, we soak the tablet in water. The cocoa peat cup gets saturated in water, as well as the cocoa peat inside. Open it into the light so you can see. You can see it's very malleable. It's good cocoa peat. Cocoa peat is great to start seedlings, because seedlings just need moisture and sunlight to start. Once you're done with the seedlings, you plant this directly into the soil, and this will break down in the soil. This will also help you with water retention once you get your plants up and running. So we have two sets. The first one is over here. We're going to plant lettuce, we're going to do kale, and we're also going to do Swiss chard. The second group, we're going to do a cabbage, cauliflower, as well as Chinese cabbage. This is what I'm using, the Jiffy Easy Cups. It's Easy Pot and Quick Swell Mix. Not sponsored, Jiffy. I'm out here. You can sponsor me, guys. Every help is needed. This thing is taking so long to dissolve. But they have it for a while though, so should be expected. The sun is going down, so light is becoming bad. I'm gonna start planting. We're gonna do 12 rows of kale, 12 rows of lettuce, 12 rows of Swiss chard, spinach. Then we'll do the rest later. But for now, let us continue. Thank you for joining me again. Once again, we ran out of battery life. Sun must set, working in the dark. You're able to get an update tomorrow morning. So my next vlog, you'll be able to see what you've done, what it looks like. Yeah, give thanks.